Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. Let's start with Mark Zuckerberg. He's been everywhere this week as Llama 3.1405b is released. Many people are saying it's better than ChatGPT 4.0, Claude's Anthropic, Sonnet 3.5, and even Google's Gemini models. We'll dive into that in a second, but first of all, watch this.
There are more than 200 million people on our platforms who consider themselves creators.
That's pretty cool. 200 million creators on Meta's platform alone.
They all have this basic issue, which is that there aren't enough hours in the day to engage with their community as much as they'd like. There's going to be a huge unlock where basically every creator can pull in all their information from social media, can train these systems to reflect their values and their business objectives and what they're trying to do.
So essentially, Zuckerberg's vision for the future is you'll be able to do community engagement while you sleep as a content creator, and even use AI to extend your reach and productivity while billions of people are talking to AI agents all over the world. That's an interview with Rowan Cheng, and I highly recommend you watch the full video. I'll link to it down below. Now, of course, the big headline coming out of this is Meta's Llama 3.1 $405 billion parameter model has been released. It took a lot of training power to get to that stage. And why are people excited about it? Well, it's free, it's open source, and many are saying it's comparable with commercial offerings from companies like OpenAI, Google, and Anthropic. So let's test it out. Well, first of all, I can't because I'm based in the United Kingdom, and I get Meta AI isn't available yet in your country. Although that might change, as we're not as regulated as the European Union. We're still quite close, so I think Meta at some point will roll this out to the UK. Please, Meta, I really hope you do. In the meantime, I think you can go and try it on Grok if you want. If you log in with Grok, you can give it a little test there. But I'm actually going to try it out on NVIDIA's NIM or NIM Playground. And here you'll see Llama 3.1 405b instruct is available to me. Let's try it out. Now, the interface is a little more clunky, a little more developer focused, but we can still give the new Llama 3.1 model a go here. And I'll just write a limerick about the wonders of GPU computing. That was super quick. That was crazy quick. I thought I'd be sitting here waiting. There once was a GPU so fine, whose parallel processing was divine. It crunched with great zest through complex math tests and made simulations truly shine. Let's give it something harder here. Analyze the causes and effects of the fall of the Roman Empire. Let's think about it. Oh, there it comes. Okay, it's multifaceted. Of course, we know that. Internal decline, corruption, economic troubles, military overextension. This is all coming through in real time right now. Barbarian invasions, Persian Empire, climate change, pandemics. Oh my goodness, there's so much there. It's going on and on. This is a good way to test out the new Llama 3.1 model. But let's give it something more content creator focused. Provide a step-by-step guide to setting up a podcast. And here it comes in real time again. Plan your podcast, define the niche, identify your target audience, develop a content strategy, create a unique name, choose your equipment, microphone, USB microphones. It recommends Blue Yeti, Rode NT-USB, or dynamic microphones. It's actually giving a really good overview of how to start a podcast. So you can see, obviously, this is a powerful model. Now, there are other videos available on YouTube where creators really go into depth with Llama 3.1, but I wanted to show you that it's available even if you're outside countries where actually you can access it via meta.ai. Just go to Grok or NVIDIA's NIM Playground, and of course, I'll make sure to link this down below so you can test it out for yourself and see how powerful this model is potentially for your own content creation needs. Now, don't worry if you feel a little bit left out and excluded that you can't access Meta's AI natively. There was another launch this week, and that is Mistral. Mistral have been really crushing out models. Obviously, they were taken over recently by Microsoft. So Mistral Large 2 has been released, and you can access it, as far as I know, anywhere in the world at chat.mistral.ai. Again, I'll place that link down below. And this is a really simple interface. I can ask it anything here. So I might just say, provide a step-by-step guide to setting up a podcast and see what comes back. And again, topic, format, target audience, name. It's fairly fast, a little bit faster than the NVIDIA Playground there for Llama 3.1. Episode, script outline, length, frequency, microphones, again, giving me different varieties. Headphones, any pair will do. I like that. Any pair will do for starting a podcast. I don't know if I'd necessarily agree with that. It goes on to editing, publishing, and submitting to podcast directories. So a nice broad overview. And again, you may have some luck with this in your content creation. It's available to everyone for free, and it is the latest bleeding edge model. Again, test it out for yourself and find out if it compares to GPT-4o, Claude's Sonnet 3.5, or the latest models from Gemini. Now let's get on to something more creative, Kling and Colors, both with a K. AI images and AI videos from, you may remember, the Chinese startup that were previewing it. It's now available here in the browser, and a link to this will be down below. By the way, if you're enjoying what I do this video every week, rounding up the best AI tools for content creators. Make sure to throw a like on this video and subscribe so you never miss another update. Now, here we are on the website, and I'm going to sign in for free credits. That sounds like a great idea. So I need to sign up first of all and give my email address. So let's do that. Okay, and I'm in, and I've got 66 free credits. So let's give it a little test. Let's go to AI videos and see what we can make. So I'm going to put in a prompt here. Extreme close-up of raindrops dripping onto a glossy surface, intricate patterns with neon lights, a kind of cyberpunk feel. And obviously we can go more creative or more relevant. I'm going to leave that in the middle. I'll leave high performance on. Length we'll leave at 5 seconds, and the ratio 16:9, typical YouTube video. Now it's going to cost me 10 credits. I can also do stuff with the camera movements if I want. I can put in negative prompts too. So it's quite comprehensive, this AI video generator. Let's give it a test. Okay, and here it is. I've got to say, the rain looks pretty good, but the way it's falling on the ground, not so realistic. That took 5.5 minutes to generate a 5-second clip on high performance mode. So yeah, looking at that, not the best I've seen. Definitely a few artifacts there, but a good first attempt. Let's try something else. Okay, for this prompt, a detailed sequence showing a barista skillfully pouring milk into espresso. I want to really see the level of detail here. I know that's quite a difficult one for AI video generators to do. It should result in a heart shape at the end, and I've used AI to enhance this prompt. I'll leave creativity and relevance in the middle. High quality, sadly, is not available. It's coming soon, otherwise I would click that. Let's make this a 10-second clip. Oh, high performance mode does not support 10-second videos. Okay, so 5 seconds is the max. Let's make this into a short style. So let's make that 9:16. And let's see if we can do something with the camera movement. Now, we've got all kinds of stuff. Let's go for a zoom, because I think that would be really good. So let's zoom that in a little bit, maybe up to 3. And we'll leave the negative prompt as blank. And we'll spend 10 more credits to generate this video. Okay, here it is. Yeah, that barista is pouring, but the milk kind of doesn't really follow the laws of physics there. It's just blobbing into the center. Nonetheless, there's almost a heart being generated at the end. And by the way, you can download this and use this on your social platforms if you so wish. Let's see how Kling AI deals with real people. And there we go. Here's our brunette green-eyed lady ready for download. Actually, that's pretty realistic, I have to say, coming from Kling AI. Looks pretty good. Finally, let's test the image generation capabilities. For the prompt, I'm going to use a whimsical scene of a small fluffy bunny hopping through an enchanted forest. I could use a reference image if I want. Setting for the aspect ratio. Actually, this is pretty good. 1024x1024 in the square format. Let's leave that default. We can choose the number of images. Let's stick with 4, and it's just 0.80 credits to generate 4 different images. And here's our first fluffy bunny. That one actually looks pretty good. I like this one. Very detailed, very realistic. Almost heading, I would say, towards Midjourney, which I consider the absolute top AI image generator in sense. Now, I'm a little disappointed that these generations are similar stylistically, but that could be an advantage if you're going for something that's very similar in style. Sometimes it's nice, though, to have different variations and options. So all of these images do actually look really good and are available to download instantly and use in your projects. Another thing to add is that you can actually bring to life an image you generated, and it will use that image as a prompt for image to video generation. Again, it's going to cost you 10 credits as before, and let's bring this image to life. Wow, and there you go. There is a whimsical bunny hopping off into the enchanted forest. How cool is that? I think this is going to be really great. Try it out for yourself. Kling and Colors AI image and AI video generation available to try out to anyone now with some free credits when you sign up. Okay, and the final tool this week I'm going to show you is Airtable Co-Builder. Now, I think this might have gone under the radar with all the other launches this week, but essentially, as a content creator, you can describe your problems, and Co-Builder will generate a custom app in seconds using AI. No code is required to make this happen. It's really, really cool. So I'm actually going to give it a quick test by trying my own prompt. So Airtable, if you've never used it before, it's basically like a spreadsheet on steroids, way better than Google Sheets for collecting all your data. So here, you just tell the Airtable builder about what app you're building. So I'm going to type in here, I want a content idea repository, store and organize content ideas and inspiration. Now you can choose a company name as well if you want and a department name. I'm just going to leave those blank. You can choose a color scheme. I'm going to use default. Let's click next and see what comes up. And there you go. Within seconds, it's given me a layout of an app that I could potentially use, the title, the status of the idea, a little description. I can scroll across as well and see whether it's a blog post, a video, a podcast, the creation date, and even the inspiration source. So this is a great way of quickly developing out apps that you can fully use in your content creation process. Let's try something else. I'll be a little bit more descriptive. I want an influencer partnership management tool that will track and manage my collaborations with companies. And I've even given a list of features here. So companies with contact details, collab history, campaign tracking, contract and payment management, task and deadline tracking. So this is very, very complicated. Let's go and change the color here. Let's make it a bright red. And in this instance, we'll give a company name, Creator Magic, and a department, Creative. And then we just click preview for Airtable Co-Builder to go ahead and build out the idea of what our app might be like. Now, in the time it took me to tell you about that, it's pretty much finished. Influencer partnership management, look at that. Companies, campaigns, contracts, tasks, all there. We've got a company name, contact person, email, just as I'd expect to see, some sample phone numbers, address, collaboration history there, and the contract. And we can actually click through all of this and see how our app will look in total. This is really cool stuff. It's all built out for me, so I can start populating this as my own tool. Now, if we're happy with what Airtable Co-Builder has created, let's click Create. And boom, within moments, this is now inside my Airtable account. As I've logged in, I've got some sample data all here ready to use, and I can go ahead and add whatever I need. So add a contract, and look at this, it pops up a form where I can populate everything. So no code to create something that's very usable by me or my team. I can just simply click share down here and invite people to collaborate with me on this app. It's really cool. I think as a content creator that needs to get ideas and company collabs and everything else organized, Airtable with its co-builder AI is going to be a brilliant solution for you. Now, if you enjoyed this, do throw a like and also subscribe to my channel as I come back here weekly with the latest AI tools I've found that I think will be handy to you as a content creator. Oh, and finally, from OpenAI, Search GPT was announced. Now, this is interesting. You can kind of search for music festivals, as you can see here in this example, and it throws out a list as it's searched the web, just like kind of Perplexity does. You can click the link, or indeed, you can ask a follow-up question such as, is this a family-friendly event? And it will come out with the conversational reply to say, yes, it is, or no, it isn't. So Search GPT, it's something you can't try now, but you can get on the waitlist for it. And again, a link to get on the waitlist is down below in the description to this video. If you never want to miss another AI tool, make sure to use the link down below to subscribe to my email newsletter where I update you weekly on the latest AI tools for content creators. Thanks for watching.